came back to Manila, I was very eager to let people try what I learned in Italy. So I would just cook small dinners for people in their homes, mostly for friends of my family or people that I was comfortable cooking for. It was a really fulfilling experience because I was just pretty much by myself and I just had one assistant. And, you know, I would come with my baskets full of the vegetables and the ingredients that I was going to cook with. And I pretty much did everything, you know, by myself. And, you know, cooking for people in that kind of very homey, very casual setting was a really good way to start. It was very fulfilling to see people enjoy the food that I cooked. At one point, I got really lucky to be invited by the general manager of what was then the Hyatt Regency on Ross Boulevard to do a food festival at their premier restaurant called Hugo's. And that was in 1987. I think at that time, there was nobody really from my background who was working with their hands. Nobody really wanted to slave over a hot stove. So I figure 1987 was pretty much when I finally broke into the industry professionally. After the two very successful food festivals, I guess my catering business got a little bit busier. The gigs started to get a little bigger. The accolades were a little bit distracting. You can get a little bit overwhelmed by all the praise and the attention. I kind of screwed up a lot. And there were events where I was like late as a caterer. And I think that this period in my life was actually the time where I learned the most. The biggest learning was coming to the realization that this business is not about the glamour and about the praise and about people telling you how great you are as a chef. But the only way to succeed in this business and to really endure is to understand that it's all about responsibility, about punctuality, about discipline. And it took me nearly 10 years to learn that. Private catering is easy because you can at least choose the nights you work, but there's still a lot of structure that's needed in your back of house to be able to do it well and making sure you deliver what you're committed to deliver. And it was that time in my life where I had to make a real major decision whether this was just going to be a hobby for me or was it something that I really wanted to pursue as a profession for the rest of my life.